Okay, shall we start our session?
Yes, madam.
Welcome back. So this session we are going to discuss about the open education resources. I have shared an URL link, that is a form, Google form link in the in the chat box. I request all of you to kindly click it and then give your inputs, your valid inputs. Okay, it is very valuable. Because I would like to build my lesson based upon your inputs given in that form. Okay, so I request all of you to give that for inputs. So, a 9 people have given your response and sharing. I hope I'm okay. 1 second, I'll just share the screen. Yes, do you know about open license? No. Fine. Great. Okay. So let me start my presentation. I had a look on it about your inputs. Hope my presentation screen is visible.
Yes, ma'am.
So here, what is OER and the journey of OER to MOOC? That is what we are going to see, particularly about the open education resources. So today we are going to discuss about this. Once again, I'll make it as full. So here, if you see, we are going to look into what is OER, why OER, then open movement, open license, then open repositories. As a teacher, how to find it, adopt it, and adapt it in our teaching learning process. And then, not only downloading it, we should also be able to upload it and get credits for our work. So how to create OER, and the journey of OER if time permits. Okay, so this is our agenda for today's session. So what is OER? So OER, if you see, it is an open education resources for teaching, learning, and research. Okay, open education resources for teaching, learning, and research that resides in the public domain. Okay, so that is freely available on the public domain or have been released under an intellectual property license that permits their free use and repurposing by others. What do you mean by that is, one is public domain, no one is going to be, that is, you have all the freedom to use it, to modify it and to share it. That is, even you need not give any credit to any creator. The other one is, yes, it has been released under the intellectual property license. Again, here also you can freely use it, share it with others, and you can also repurpose according to the license you have, according to the permitted license. Okay. So this is open education resources. So it can be a full course, it can be a course material, or it can be a module, or it can be a textbook, streaming videos, test software, any tool, okay, any tool or a technique that support to access to information or the knowledge is called OER. So this is the definition given by William Flora Hewitt Foundation and UNESCO in 2002. Okay, they have said that it is teaching, learning, research material in any medium. Mostly it is in digital. It can be non-digital also. That resides in public domain or have been released under a open license that permit no cost access, use, adaptation, and distribution by others with or no limited restriction. And this comes under the very big umbrella called open solution or open philosophy, where you have the open source software, open access, open data, open science, even many, many open things. where it has been built because through the crowdsourcing platform. Okay, so this is regarding the open education resources. The same thing, I'm repeating it here. Okay, so why you want OER? Why there should be OER? Fine. So why? So you can put it in the chat. You can tell me why there should be a OER. Why we should learn about it? Why madam has to give me a topic, talk about this OER, why it is so essential? So you can just put it in the thing. Can you tell me? Or just type some one other reasons. Or you can unmute and you can tell me. See, let us say, for example, even what is the gross enrollment ratio in higher education in India? The gross enrollment ratio in higher education in India is around 26%. Our new national education policy says that by 2035, the gross enrollment ratio should be doubled. That is, it should be 50%. That means 1 in 4 goes in for the higher education. Others are not able to go for higher education. Why? There may be many reasons. And the first reason is the factor is that is it is expensive. Okay, the higher education is expensive. Maybe till school education they could have had free education, and there is no free education in what is it? In our higher education, so either he goes for a professional course or even for any degree courses, it is not free, isn't it? So it is cost everywhere. In our country also, there is no, okay, school education, to some extent you have some free education also, but it is not free for everyone. There are some categories. In some countries, certain school education, it is free, in Bhutan and other things. You're right. But here, it is not so. Then how do you increase the gross enrollment ratio? Because they are not able to pay their fees, even if they, let us say, through some scholarship or through something, they enter into the institute, they are not able to cope up with the cost of the book. They cannot buy books every time. The expenses, so they have to have a livelihood. So they, what they do is they earn for their family. They want to do that. So most of them drop. Even after joining also, you can see some dropouts. And particularly during this pandemic, there are a lot of dropouts in schools and colleges. Okay, so that is a big issue, not only in India, all over the world. Cost. Higher education is very expensive. So what can we do as a teacher, as a learning community? What can we do? Should we tell them to buy books? Now, is it possible for them to buy books during this pandemic situation? No. So what should you do? There are so much of resources available. What we can do is we can collect those information. You know, you are the expert in that content. You know which is right, which is wrong, which is authentic, which is suiting your target audience, that is your students. You can curate those resources. You can give it to your students for them to learn. Instead of telling them, refer this book, refer that book, you can get those things and give it to their students to learn. You can That becomes your content where you are going to create, you are going to remix, okay? It is not totally your content, maybe somebody's else. So you are going to, but you have the authority to do it. Then you can remix it and then give it, curate it and then give it to your students. In that sense, you are not going to reinvent the wheel, as well as you are going to reduce the cost of the books at least. Okay, usually our students will not buy books every semester. No, it is very difficult. Even teachers also finding it difficult, right? They are, we depend upon the library or book loans. Definitely your students will be depending upon those things. And moreover, it will be outdated. Next time, that too, if in computer science, there is no use of buying books at all, right? So for some basic core things, you need books. For other things, no, for other programming languages and all, instead of going for books, it is better to go for online books or online tutorials or online materials, right? So in that case, it is we need OER so that we are not going to reinvent the wheel again from the scratch. You need not do it. Okay, something is available, you can build upon it and you can make it better, 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 and the best. Okay, and then next is sharing is good practice, sharing and caring. So we can share whatever we have produced to the whole world. So only we upload so much things, no? You take a selfie and then upload it on the thing. So you create something, you upload it on the media, that is social media. That is one thing. And sometimes, no, you have like, let us say for example, you cannot give it free every time, no? So you might be like, few people might be thinking, okay, so I have spent so much amount of time, energy, money to get this expertise, I cannot give it free. Okay, well, since it is in the teaching community, it is mandatory, you have to support or facilitate the learning process. In that case, you can also give it free by getting the credits. Okay, so you will be getting the credits for that, right? But you can share it with others. So sharing is good practice for public good and for fair use. Okay, the next is capacity building, where you can improve on it and you can build good materials, authentic materials, which the rest of the world can use it. Breaking down barriers to learning. So only, see, sometimes you get a few hours to children gets opportunity. Not all children gets opportunity to learn everything. So accessibility is a big problem. Equity is a problem. So the three cardinal principle of our Department of Education is accessibility, particularly the SWAYAM MOOCs and other things, the e-content. First is accessibility, second is equity, third is quality. Okay, so every learner should be able to access any type of material without any left out. See, it should not be only for an elite group or only for this urban people or for this people. So it should be an inclusive education where socially, economically, physically challenged people, for everyone, it should be they can be able to access it. That is equity and quality. See, since it is we have a tendency, no, if it is free, it is of not that quality. No, we are going to generate and we are going to share it. So quality also is very, very important. The SWAYAM MOOCs quality may be, in the beginning, it will not be equal similar to the Coursera, edX, Udemy, that type, but still it is evolving, and we Indians, we are making it better and better to give good quality content for teaching learning process. So breaking down barriers to the learning. Then networking between teaching practitioners. So in that case, when you share, when you give, when you have some open license, you can create some hubs, you can create some networks between the teaching practice. Okay, you can have interaction between the institutes or international things. So that is another one. Then cross fertilization of idea between discipline. That also. So multidisciplinary, so you can find out, okay. So when it is open only, we can come to know that, okay, these things have been dealt by this person. So a lot of ideas you can get it. And from that, we can really solve the real world problem. For these reasons, OER is very, very important. So we saw what is OER, then why OER, and next is what you can do with this OER. You can use it, you can share it with anyone because it is free and it is open to, and you can also improve. Improve means you can adapt, repurpose, improve under some type of license, not everything. Sometimes, no, I create something, I share it on the internet. When it is available on the internet, it is free for anyone to download it. okay, but I will put a license, okay, you can use it, you can, it is free, you can use it, but use it as it is, do not modify it. So like that also I can give some license. I can also give, okay, you can use it freely, you can adapt it, whatever you want, you can do it, but for non-commercial purpose. So it, since you're a creator, you can do it in whatever way you want it, okay, the copyright. I will put a question now. Let us say, for example, you are taking a picture, okay? You are having a 4K camera or a very best megapixel phone or something like that. You have it, right? Good camera, you have it, and you have time. Now in pandemic, you cannot travel, but just imagine, okay? We are going into an imaginary world, okay? So you are going to a place, waiting, let us say Kanyakumari itself, okay? So waiting for the sunset and sunrise, right? You're capturing, one day you're waiting, some clouds are there, you're not able to correctly capture that scene. Excuse me. Then you're coming next day and then trying to do it, you got a very beautiful picture, right? You enjoy that picture which you have taken, okay? That every time you see that picture, it gives you such a good joy for you. Now, you can keep, it is your thing, right? You have taken a picture with your camera, with all those things, it is yours. Now, you want to show it to others, no? Like, see, such a great picture, you want to show it. Or you can also give it free, or you can share it with others. You can say, okay, if you like it, you pay me. You can use it in your some video or some places. Okay, in that, it is up to you to do that. I'm just giving an example, right? Okay. So in that case, so let us say, for example, you're taking a selfie, put it in the social media. Let us say Facebook, something like YouTube or whatever it is, a video or an image. Now, who is the owner of that? An image or video, whatever content you put, okay? Who owns it or who has the copyright? Yes. Who has the copyright? Dear participants, you're there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So who has a copyright? See, it should be active. Like I need active participation. Otherwise, I'll be talking to the screen. See, everybody takes picture, right? We upload so many things daily in our Facebook or in some social media. If not, also imagine then. Who owns the copyright for all those things?
Myself.
Yes, somebody is giving the answer. So what is it? What is the participants are there? Anbarasan, Anbarasi, Anurana. Yes, Kannadasan, you're trying to say something, but I'm not able to get it. Can you please repeat it, sir? I think the Facebook has it. Raja M.A. says that. He's thinking that the Facebook has the copyrights. Okay. Any other answer to support or not to support Raja? What about Kannadasan, sir? Like you said something, but I'm not able to get it, what it was. So you're thinking or you know that? If you know, you can give the answer. You can give guesswork. Here, nothing, I'll tell you, nothing wrong. Whatever is your assumption, what so far you are assuming something, who has a copyright? We should know all these things, okay? Social media in which we share, Vijay, Karthik, okay, social media. Now come, please, come out so that I will tell you which is right. So that we should be very clear, no? We are in this world, we are using so much of social media in our daily life, in our teaching learning process. The one who takes or owns a picture owns a copyright. Yes, Monisha, Maria Monisha, very nice answer. Yeah. So one who took the picture. Okay, Vijay Vignesh. Good. Good to know, like both the sides I am getting the answers. One says that one who has created that person has a copyright. Yes, another says that social media is having. No. Whoever is a creator, like as Monisha said, Vignesh said, the people who have created, no, they have the copyright. When you are creating the picture, automatically it is protected under copyright. Let us say you are putting it on some media, internet, on the net you are uploading it. So internet, what it does, it enables you anything to be shared. Why you have internet for only for sharing, communicating only for sharing. So when you create something, you have automatically it is protected under copyright. And when you put it on the internet enables you to share. But still, the copyright is with the creator only. He or she who has created, and that person has a copyright. You can put it in any media, but you can give things. Let us say you are uploading it in some repository. You could have seen some photos, some images like Flickr, Instagram, PictoChart. These are the big repositories of images. Since I took images, I'm giving that example. If you see videos, you can say YouTube. So much of YouTube is there. Videos are there, sir. So much of videos in YouTube are there. Then Vimeo is there. Like these are the different repositories where you have images, where you have videos. Music is another industry, like sound and all those things, right? So in that case, when you upload it, it will ask you what rights you want, whether you want, you can have, because it is your own thing, you can have the copyright, or you can say, okay, I'm putting it public domain, no rights reserved. Copyright is all rights reserved. The next is no rights reserved. Okay, so in that case, what happens is, the other one is in between no rights reserved and all rights reserved, you have some rights reserved. That is the open license. I'll show you the slides once again. Yeah. So with those, what I say is, I'll come to that point again. Right. Now, the David Willis in 1998, he has given the 5 R's of openness. What it is? It is retain, reuse, revise, remix, and redistribute. That is, retain is you have the rights to make, you have the rights to access it, you can own it, you can store it, manage it, whatever. That is called retaining. Okay. Then reuse it, you have the rights to use it as it is. You can use it. You can use it in a study group, you can use it in a class, you can use it on a website, or you can use it in a view. Video, you are using it as it is in any places that you have the rights to use it. Revises, you have the rights to adapt, adjust, modify, or alter the content itself. So let us say very good video is there, but it is in American English, which our students will not be able to understand, let us say. Or let us say it is in it is in English, you wanted to give it in your local language, your regional language. So what you can do is, you can, if it is open and if you have the open license, where you can modify it, you can give your voice over in your own language, in your accent, and then you can do it, right? You can share it with your with anybody, to the whole world. So that is a revise. Then remixes. You have the right to combine the original or the revised content with the other open content to create something new. So you can create something new, okay? You mix it up. That is called remix. As we have songs, no, remix songs. But you should have the, you have to really clear the copyright of the person who has created or get the copyrights from him to remix the same lyrics or the music or whatever. Music, you will put it according to that. The same way you can do it in our anything, any content. It can be any learning content. So redistributors right to share copies of the original content, your revision, your remixes with others. So give a copy to your content to your student, to your friends. You have all the liberty to share it with your students. Okay. So these are the 5 R's of openness. And the next is share. See, usually what we do as a teacher, we create the learning things. Okay, annotate. So we create, you know, like, let me see. So sorry, this is kind of hitting the color change. Fine. This is ink. Fine. So this, let us say this is your learning activity. You create it, you share it among your students. So within the class, it's okay. But when you want to designate this learning activity as this learning resources, that is open educational resources, you have to follow these rules. What are these rules? So one is clearing the copyright issues. Second is formatting for the web and accessibility for reuse. Third is addition of descriptive metadata. Then publishing it in repository or on web. So as soon, so whenever you are creating any activity or any resources, so if you have taken from somebody else, see to that that does not have any copyright issues. You have the freedom to use it. Like if you have some copyright issues, let us say, if you have taken some copyrighted article or any image or whatever it is, you have to clear it. Either get permission or pay for it. Whatever that person is asking, you have to do it. Right? So that is what clearing of copyright issues. Then format it in the way you want it. And then for the web accessibility. So that is automatic. Any software, when you're uploading, it will automatically take care. And it is easy to upload and download these days. Okay. So then publish it in the repository or in the web. So this is how you can make a learning activity or a learning resources as a open education resources. Fine. And next is you're able to see the screen, no? Right? Oh, I have. So the next is what has enabled the OER is, see, many things like the social, that is, first thing is the change in philosophy, the openness, everything is open. For example, let us say you are all civil engineers and you are doing a lot of projects, okay? You need, let us say in GIS and other things, whatever it is, even in environmental engineering, you might require, I'm just giving an example, you might require a map, okay? So now the Google map is there, you are using it very easily. In those days, no, before Google map was available for everyone to use it, we have to really go to a something like a TTK maps or something like that, and we used to get the digital maps. Then you have to pay an amount for it. And then we have to use it in our projects. So let us say corporation wants to dispose all the garbages in Chennai at the right time, in the right place. Okay. So for that, you need the maps of the Chennai map. And then you have to do some PERT, CPM, whatever it is, to calculate all those things. So what happens now? Now the map is available free. Any student or anybody can work on this Google map. Like if you see, so many apps have come and so many people are using in our day-to-day life also, like Ola, Uber, Swiggy. Everybody is using Google map. Is it pay? are you paying? You also, like whenever you want to travel, you just put a destination to it and it will say take left, take right, take a U-turn, something like that. It says us and it directs us and we go and reach the destination, right? So are you paying for that? No, you are paying only for the data, that is ISP, internet service provider. You are not paying for the Google or you are not paying for anything else. So because it is open, and because it is open, lot of innovation, lot of applications, everything has come. And if you look into the education sector also, many things are open. See, when you want to go, let us say in those days, when I was doing my computer science and engineering first batch of Madras University, what happened is in that time there was no internet. So we have to depend upon the books or the library. So we used to run to the library, so time, and then you have to access the book. Even for the dictionary, if you want to have a meaning for something, dictionary is a big thing, no? Like in every house, our parents used to try to bring a dictionary so that we are able to look into it and learn the vocabularies and other things, right? So now is it there? I do not know. How many people now, the present generation, is referring to the physical thing, okay? So we had encyclopedia, dictionaries and other things those days. Now it has all been replaced by the online dictionaries, even the whatever software we are using for documentation, it itself gives you the prompt, what it is, and immediately the spelling, everything is there, no? Then and Wikipedia. See, now you have the Wikipedia, which is open. You don't pay for anything. You get anything to learn, right, from that. So that is an open philosophy. Then the affordness of internet. So all this is possible because of the internet technology and cloud computing, where you can store many things in all forms, not only text. You are able to store any type of data, spatial data, temporal data, multimedia data, big data, everything. Yeah, so everything comes as a big data, right? And range of financial, there's a range of financial, see, who is going to develop all those things? So when you are going to, is there any sound coming? Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
Yeah, okay. Suddenly there's sound. Okay, fine. Then the next is the financial models. There are so many financial models, like starting from our ministries, endowment, then philanthropists, like what do you say? So many people support it. So if you look into the world, you have OER Africa, OER Asia, OER Commons, or Commonwealth of Learning. So UNESCO, from starting from UNESCO. So many people are financing it so that it should, all the resources should be accessible by everyone, and everyone should have the accessibility to the quality things. Okay. Excuse me. Then let us say, for example, the pioneer in this open education resources is MIT, Massachusetts Institute of Technology. From 2001 onwards, they started creating this, and it's a very big repository where you have all the courses, no? Starting from 2001, many courses are terminated as an open education resources, which is available for the whole world, where we can use it freely for learning, for teaching, and for research purpose. And definitely legally, this is right, because you have the right to use it, you have the right to share it, revise it, remix it, and redistribute it. So it is legally, and it is so only, it is called copyleft movement. It is an alternative to the copyright movement. And all this should be for the public use and for fair use, for the public good and for fair use. So a lot of movements, I said, no, like the open movement, open society, open access journal, open licenses are there, that we'll see in detail. Open science, open data, a lot of things, no? So if you If you want to get solution for many of our world problem, these data, see, for COVID, the data should be available. So they are doing so much of data, and they are predicting it, how it will be there and all those things. So data becomes, if the data is not available for people, then how innovations, research will happen. So openness will lead to innovation, okay? So you have a lot of movement like open source software, open source hardware, open standard, open access, open design, open knowledge, open data, open content, open courseware, open educational resources, and open educational practices, okay? So the practicing also now, many universities, you know, like some institutions and universities are adopting this open educational resources in their teaching learning process, thereby reducing the cost of the tuition fee, books, and other things also. It is there. The case studies are in Canada, in many countries, they are practicing it as an institution itself, as an education practice itself. Okay, so these things I have already told you, like who are going to fund all these things to make it. So what will happen when you create and share something on the internet? The question which I asked, it is automatically protected under copyright. Okay, it is automatically protected under the copyright. Fine. And then next is, but online does not equally openly license. That means whatever is available on the internet, do you have the rights to use it? My next question. When you create it and upload it, now you are very clear, social media does not have any copyright of yours. It is yours only. It is a platform for us to share it. But who has the copyright? You only are having, whoever is created and uploaded is having the copyright. The creator has in the copyright. Okay, it is automatic. You need not go and get some license like our driving license or other car. You don't go, like patent is different. Patent you have to apply and get it, right? That is different. When you are uploading anything on the digital media, that is the internet, automatically it is protected. It is you have created, you have the ownership, right? So when the problem comes, when somebody downloads it and misuses, which you don't want it to do, then only problem comes. See, so for example, you are a very good teacher, okay? You have bought a very good book, very costly also, ebook, you have got it. Oh, you enjoyed that book and then you want to share it with your students only, right? So what you do is you have given a copy of the book to all your students. You have put it in some in your web portal or in your blog, or let us say through some media you have shared, for example, on your WhatsApp or somewhere you have shared with your things. Your intention was good. That is, okay, it's a very good book. It's expensive. I have bought it because I'm earning, but I want to give my students. So how can I do that? So you have done. Is it right or wrong? Is it right or wrong? Can you do it? Ma'am, what about the expiry of your copyright after certain years? And for education purpose, we can use copyright files. I'll come to that, right? See, copyright, it has some so many years, no? Like 100, I will show you the content. So many years you can have it automatically, that copyright after for every different types of materials, you have some years, okay? You can have that, then it becomes open. Like it is very more like 100 years, something like that, okay? For education purpose, we can use copyright files. You can use, we are using it, but is it ethically or legally, it is not good, okay? We should be sure that if it is between you and your students, where you are not using any internet, uploading on the internet and sharing, there will be no issues, okay? But legally or ethically, it is not correct. My question is now, okay, the same question as Raja asked in a different way I'm putting it. So I have bought a book, I have paid money, and I have bought a e-book, okay, on some good in our discipline. I am sharing it with their students. I'm just giving a copy, no e-book, PDF, just share it. Yeah, you can't share as author of the book. No, even author will not have the copyright. No, he is published, and the publisher will have the copyright. Like, because the publisher pays some amount to the author, author will not have copyright, okay, unless otherwise there is some terms and condition, whatever it is there. Okay, he can take it to the publisher. See, your book has been like that, he can put a report it, but the publisher has all the rights to come and sue us, okay? Either we have to be behind the bars or we have to pay a big amount to the publisher. So this has happened in 2014. I have a case study in US, and history teacher, where he shared a book which cost around $4 on his website. And after a few months, he got a notice that he has to go for two months imprisonment, or he has to undergo that, or he has to pay some big amount. He was saying, see, I bought this book, and then, no, it is not legally allowed. You can try this. Let us say if somebody is having a blog, say now during this pandemic, everybody started some YouTube or blog or whatever it is. So whenever you write something, okay, writing, you are doing it, fine. And you want to put some pictures, okay? If it is your own picture, no problem. If it is somebody pictures which is having a copyright, which is not having open license, then the problem. After some time, you can see it has been removed. And music industry is very, very, strict. This at least comes after their knowledge, a few days or few hours, it may differ. Music industry, immediately the day itself, you will get all those things. See, you can try it with the Facebook. This also, we had all these occasion in our journey. So when there was a annual day in our institute, some children were playing dancing for the old Tamil song. Okay, so one of our colleagues, they captured it on the mobile and then uploaded it in her Facebook. Then after a day, the music alone has been removed. Okay, this is one instant. The other instant is what happened is one of the professor, okay, he made a very good video. For that, he wanted to give a background music, BGM. Okay, so he took some music and then uploaded in YouTube. Immediately, it was removed, and things were given to him that he had no copyrights to use that music as a BGM. Okay, but he is not going to make any profit. But still, see, that is somebody else without knowing. You cannot use it. So that is what. So I think so. It's right because I got it, and now I want it. It's mine now. This is said. Maria says, I think so, it is right because I have bought it and now I own it and it is mine now. So it is my wish to share it or not. You have owned it, you can do whatever. You can retain, you can reuse, okay? But whether you have the rights to redistribute it, whether you can give it to others, no. If you see the terms and condition, for you only you have written. See, you're all professors. Like you might be using so many software, no, for your structural analysis, all those things, right? So when there are some proprietary software, open source software. When you are using 10 license, 15 license, or 20 license, you buy. If it go beyond it, does it support? Sometimes we buy it, but usually it does not do it, right? So it stops it. It is legally not permitted to do it. So even if you have bought it, let us for so many users, means so many users only should use. Okay? So that issues is there when you buy it. So what can we do, madam, for For all these things, where you can go by or put a mail to him and say, okay, sir, can I use it? Professor, can I use it? Should I ask like that? No. There are many, many places where really you can see it. No, let us say, for example, I'll show you how to search. Have you used, see, everybody have used Google images, okay? Let us say for your for our presentation or for something in our, for our classes, you need to prepare some material, maybe slides or something. So you get some good, we will not sit and draw ourselves, no? So whatever is available, with that we will start doing it. So which, whether, and then let us say you want to publish it as a book or as a material, you create a MOOC content, whether you have rights to use it or not. So there you am I? Fine. So let me. Or I have to prepare a presentation on blockchain technology. So I will put blockchain technology. I have prepared some material. Then I'll go to the images. So many images are there. Whichever suits me or whichever I like it, I download it and put it in my PPT. That usually we do it, right? Fine. In this, see, but when you want to share it on the slide share, putting it your name, okay, created by so-and-so, developed by so-and-so, in that case, you should be very, very, what do you say? You should be very cautious. Okay, fine. So let us say, for example, this is one, okay, this image I want to use it, or this image I want to use it. See, when I put this, here it says images may be subject to copyright. Okay, so you're able to see this one, images may be subject to copyright. If you click here, learn more, now you can see what is copyright means, okay? Can Google determine the copyright? What is the difference between the copyright and trademark? What is the difference between the copyright and piracy? Okay, so this is a very short one. You can just go through it, okay? will Google determine the copyright ownership? No, it says a big no here. That means, see, Google is a search engine which will index the information, web pages, images, audio, video, books, maps, so many things it is doing. Its motto is to organize the world information. So it is organizing and keeping it so that we are easily able to find it and use it. Okay, for finding it, for using. So for what is copyright, what is fair use, everything you can learn here, right? So now, see, many types of works are eligible for copyright protection. For example, audiovisual work like TV shows, movies, online videos, sound recording and music composition, written works such as lectures, articles, books, music composition, visual works such as painting, poster, advertisement, video games and software, computer software, dramatic works such as play, all these are eligible for copyright protection. Automatically, when you create and upload it, it is yours, right? Now, how I want to use some images, okay? So what I do is go to tools, usage rights, go to usage rights, go to Creative Commons license. This is open license. Creative Commons is an open license. Go here. See here, so this, any picture I can use it. These are all open source, open licensed pictures. So many pictures are there, right? Even in Wikipedia, Wikimedia, these are the pictures. Even in Flickr, you can find out, not all, you have to find. How to find? See, let us say, for example, I want this one. Okay, beautiful, first one. Right, it is in Flickr. Okay, click Flickr here. Okay, so this is the image. And see here, public domain. See the symbol zero, zero. You are able to see that? Public domain. That means anybody can, you can, I can download it. See the download button, I can download it, I can share it. Okay, I can share it in anything. I can download it and use it here. Okay, I need not give any attribution or any credit to the person who has created, right? So this is an, it is in public domain. So nobody will question, hey, did you create this? You're using this. Yes, it is a, it is in public domain. No, it is no rights reserved. Anybody can use it. Even I can alter it, I can modify it. I can put different pictures here and I can use it, okay? The same way, yeah, the previous. So let us say, for example, anything else we'll see. Pixabay. So this is in the Pixabay. Okay, so these are the image repository. See here, it is saying free download, free for commercial use. You can put it when you want to write an article on blockchain. My top page should contain this picture. No, I can put it. I can sell that book also. But this image, I can use it because it is free for commercial use. No attribution required. No attribution required me. You need not give even the credit who has done it. Likewise, you can have many pictures here. Okay. See here, this picture I am taking, it will say lower price. Price is there. When I go for this iStock. Okay, so this, if I download it, okay, I can download it, I can say I can save image like this, I can use it. But what happens, you get this iStock at the background. Okay, that means we used to have, no, on our in olden days, vessels, if they buy, used to print the name on the vessels. The same way on any images, now they will put their things. That means it is taken from that place. Okay, if you don't mind, you can use it, but it is not, you cannot use it everywhere, right? The same, so this one, like that you can find out. So you go back to this one. So what I want you to do is go to tools, go to, you, all means everything mixed up, you will get it. So you do not know whether it is under copyright or other. So go and select the Creative Commons license. So these images are coming under the Creative Commons license. Now you should know what is it. Okay, we'll come back to this again. We'll go to our slides. Okay, where is it? Did I close it? Okay, I was using the other one. Sorry. It's a previous one. Hope you are able to see my screen. Yeah, please tell me, otherwise I...
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So you are able to see my screen, no? So that is what, see, whenever I take any picture, let us say I wanted a beautiful dog, so I took it from Flickr, but it is having some license, Creative Commons license. So I have to attribute it. So this is a picture taken from this. Author is some Lila, fill in Lila. And then I have to give the what is license. So this is the correct way to give the attribution to the picture. So usually what we do, we use a picture and we don't bother. But when this is a legal, ethical way to do it. Okay, so now we will be learning about this, what is it? The CC license, the Creative Commons license, which is called the open license. Now you know this, this is the copyright. This is the open public domain, that is zero you saw, no? If you have zero or you can have PD, PD is for public domain. So this is all right reserved, this is no rights reserved. In between you can have some rights reserved. See, you want to share it to the thing. But when you want to share it, you want, it is up to you. You can have the copyright. you need not share it. Even if you want to share it, you can share it with some amount. No, you can make money of it. That is, it is left to you. But let us say you want to give it to the whole world for the public good and for fair use, then you can. But you want the credit. Okay, I don't want money, but I because I am getting paid for my teaching. So for this, I am going to give. I am going to create out of my interest, and then I want to share it with my from my colleagues or to my students. So or anything. So here in open educational resources, like for the software, you have GNU license, GPL license, Berkeley license, like that. Just open license like that. In open educational resources, we have the Creative Commons license, that is called the CC license. When you see the CC, that means it is open content. Okay, so the e-content, that is the open content, where you can freely use it, share it, then modify it, remix it. So here you have to learn the four things. One is attribution, non-commercial, no derivative, share alike. What is attribution? Whenever you see this by symbol, no, that means you have to give credit to the author or creator. Okay, so whenever you see this by symbol, one is zero will be there. Means zero means it's a public domain, you need not give any credit. Okay, but if you see the by symbol with CC, mostly comes with by symbol. When it sees the by symbol, that means you have to give the credit to the author. Then if you see this dollar, okay, or euro or dollar, something like this, that means it is banned for commercial use. You can use it only for non-commercial purpose. Another thing is equal to. Equal to is no modification, no derivation. You have to use as it is. You can freely use it. You can share it, right? But you should not revise or remix it. The next is share alike. Share alike is, see, what is the difference between this and this is, you can do whatever you wanted, but you have to credit. Here also you can do whatever you wanted, you can remix, revise, you can redistribute it, give credit, and when you have some revision or remix, you should also share it with the same license. Okay, that is called share alike. Okay. So these are the different license. So whenever you are uploading anything, any picture on any web repository, it will ask you. Even in LMS, it will ask you if you are using Moodle or if you are using Canvas. When you are uploading a course or creating a course, or when you are uploading any resource or activities, what license you wanted. It is left to you. You can use copyright or you can use CC license. Like any, you can choose any of these. It is left to you. But these, when you are accessing others' material, you have to really look into it, and accordingly you have to use it. Okay. So if you see this one, this is most restrictive. This is not open. This is least restrictive, which is open. In between you have. So when you see these symbols, you can share it. When you see this symbol, you can share it and remix it. That is equal to means you cannot revise it. When you see this symbol like this and this too, you can use it for commercial purpose. You can remix it. You can share it. So this is the free culture. The green part is called the most free culture. Little less, and no, it is not a free. Okay, so this is how the diagram gives a clear picture. Okay, so what we have seen is, what is OER? It can be any curriculum, material, or mixed media which is discoverable online, which can be shared freely and openly. We have seen the open license CC, where you can legally use by anyone to repurpose, improve, and redistribute. Now we will see about the open repositories. Okay. Now, let us say, for example, you have to tell me whether you are able to see the screen. Otherwise, I'll close all these so many windows I opened. Okay, 23 people have given your inputs. So yes, 75%, very nice. Do you know about open license SCC? See, 65% people said no and 35%. So very good. Now you could have learnt about how to use the what is CC, okay? That is a Creative Commons license. Have you used OER in your teaching learning process? Yes is only 39 people have said, 12 people have said no, and 3 people have said I do not know. So more than around 65%, they are not knowing they have to use the OER in your teaching learning process. Have you visited any OER repository? Yes is only 7, and rest 17 people out of 24 have given no. Name any 2 OER providers. Very good. Open Course Library, Open Education Consortium, Wikipedia, MIT. Very nice. Yeah, NPTEL, SWIM, College Open Books, NPTEL. Oh, yes. Okay, MIT Courseware, NPTEL, Not Aware, Google Slides, Easy Teach. Okay, Khan Academy, TED, good, edX. Okay, good. Oasis, good. NDL, usually used to refer textbooks. Okay, Udemy, it may be open, but content is open. Okay, right. Future Skills, okay, right, good. Have you created? No. 100% no. Are you familiar with open textbooks? Yes. There's only 9, others are not. So now, looking into your inputs, now I am going to give you a lot of resources where you can really do that, right? So what is it? See, MIT OCW. This is one of why I want to show this, because they are the pioneer, and you get a lot of connections. Okay, see, just if you go, see, have you seen any, see here, see the license here, what is the license say? CC by NCSA, that means it is open license. It is free for us to use it, reuse it, that is retain, reuse, then what else? Revise, I can remix. Okay, but I can use it only for non-commercial purpose. I cannot download it, make a copy of it and sell it, okay? So it is for non-commercial purpose. And if I do any modification division also, you should also use the same type of license, okay? That is called the share alike. Okay, what is it? Now you're all, so can I have any content which you want to know for your future classes or future courses? Just put the name of the course or topic or title. It will be helpful. Otherwise, so it will be helpful for all others. If you are all, this is a program on structural engineering. No? What is it? Civil. Okay, right. See, go here.
Strength of materials.
Okay. Good, sir. Thank you, sir. So, fine materials. Topic. Okay, go to topic. Go to engineering. Engineering. We are all civil engineers. Okay, go to civil engineering. Okay, see here. Construction. What is it? Construction management, geotechnical, structural, surveying, all those things. So strength of materials will come in structural, no? Okay, mechanics. See here, so many courses are available as an open courseware for graduate, postgraduate level, right? So let us say structural engineering design or concrete. Or even you can just put for your thing, and I'll just show it and then come back to that. Okay. Which I have want to choose here, like anything you can choose. Basic structural design, technology, materials and construction. Let us say, for example, it was offered in 2004, right? 2007. So they have it. Let us say, for example, we are going to get. Or if you want the latest also, you can do it. Right, so it should be available as a course. Okay. Building technology, materials, so view course. When you view the course, you can see that, so it is offered in MIT, the professor, whatever they have taken, It has been shared to the whole world. So you can look into the syllabus. So this is the syllabus, course outline, scope of the course, values to insist. See, so intended results, that is our course outcomes, no, or the objectives that has been given. Calendar, now that will be okay. So topic one, core foundation, foundation diagram, sustainable design, architecture, exterior, and all those things, right? And then reading, all the reading materials will be available. Okay, then lecture notes. See, everything will be available. So most of it, you see, sometimes all this PDF is available. You can download it. Study materials, okay? Assignment, quiz, everything is there, right? Long answers, question paper, all these things. Oh, good. See, this and all, we don't have time. See, unless otherwise you create it, or you can, what you can do is you have all the rights to download it, modify according to your requirement, and you can do it, right? So this is one thing. As a course, you can find out the course where, you can see, download the course material. Just you can start download it. Only the videos you have, see, for help to download the course material, frequently asked questions, just start download it. So most operating system will compress, all this will be compressed together as a WinZip or PKZip, and you can use it, right? So because it is an open license, so like this you can start, you can find the course. Usually MIT will have course numbers. If you know the course numbers, you can do it, or you can just search by using the words, okay? Online textbooks are available, okay? So let us say for civil and environmental engineering, civil engineering, structural analysis and control, structural mechanics, okay, design of electromagnetic, project management, computational geometry. So these are the books they have created, and it is available to the whole world. So you can just go here, let us say project management. So this is the textbook is available online for free viewing. So just go click here. So this is, and see, you can share this in your Google Classroom also. There is no problem, okay? So people can go one by one, the design and cost, construction. So it's an ebook, right? So they can learn. Even chapter wise, you can share, download it and share it. Or you can give a link to this. So all these things are available, okay? So this is regarding the MIT OCW. And then you have Open University, right? And then the best thing is OER Commons. Okay, OER Commons is a, OER Commons. This is a big repository where you can find the open education resources. Go here, okay, you can discover the resources, you can collect, you can see so many collections are there, so many providers. And these materials are authentic because they are coming through these universities, okay? Universities or educational projects. See, all these things, Arizona State University, like for any subject, California Academy of Science, you can see that so many things are available. So whatever they are designating as open education resources, they can do Harvard School of Education. Many things are there. If you are fond of some thing, you can go directly for the Ministry of Education, Rwanda. Like that, even the Ministry OER Africa, the continental, subcontinent. Like that, see, NASA is giving. So all these are open education resources which you can use it, okay? Otherwise, you can also go and see the resources. Let us say, right. So subject wise you can do it, or you can also find out strength of materials. Strength of materials, somebody said. I'm just putting it, search. Okay, so there are 243 results, strength of materials. So what it is, see, student learn about variety of material used by the engineers. So it is an activity lesson plan, teach engineering. Very nice, no? Okay, we'll see what it is. Okay, go here. See here, you can share it with the Google Classroom also. Just to see, the Google Classroom is there. Before that, you should know what it is, okay? Who has done it, Teach Engineering has done it. The author names are given. It is an activity. It is only for the grade Architecture and Design Engineering, middle school level it is. Okay, view. Okay, strength of materials, okay? So this is an activity, so engineering construction, plans, all worksheets, strength of material worksheets are there, you can, what is it? I do not know, you have to check it up, right? So more curriculum, pre-knowledge, so it will give you more introduction, motivation, what it does, all these things, you know, so many good, see, all these are there. Strain versus stress, concrete, steel, and this is at the school level they are taking. Okay, so what we, no problem, you can use it whatever you want it, you can share it with your students, okay? This is free material, you can share it in your Google Classroom, or you even you can WhatsApp here, from here itself you can WhatsApp the material, or you can put it in your Google Classroom if you have the Google Classroom. You can see to that, this is my classroom, it comes. So you can share it to your Google Classrooms, okay? And then you can share your materials in your lessons and other things. So teach engineering, okay? STEM curriculum, very nice. And then what happened? So likewise, no, according to your request, this is a very good resources. And you have to find out, you have to go through the resources, find, because you are an expert, you know whether it suits your audience, whether all those things, okay? Essential mechanics. And see, what is this? Statics and strength of material with MATLAB and Octave. So this is, see the license, everywhere it is given. This is CC BY. You give acknowledgement. This is P. Venkatraman. From RIT, that is Rochester Institute of Technology. He has added on 14.1, very good, okay. So here, so many people have viewed, so many saved. So essential mechanics, okay. So you can view the resources, go here, see the resources. Structural analysis. So it is getting downloaded. So essential mechanics, statics and strength of material with MATLAB and Octave. So nice. So it is, see, it is a, like a material, no? So this is, it is in open. See, this is a free ebook released under the Creative Commons license. You can put a link itself, give a link here. Even you need not download it and do it. Give a link to your student. Let them use it. Okay, if they wanted to do it. See, this has been IIT Kanpur alumni. So he's an alumni of IIT Kanpur. Now he's working in the US. Very nicely they have created Why MATLAB. Essential Foundation in Engineering series. See, you can find lot of resources like this. Okay, so they are the person, no, R. Venkatraman, authored. Okay, fine units. Why mass probes went off the course. So it is taking me to something else, whatever questions. So there are a lot of learnings. Because I am just browsing it along with you. So I have done for my computer science subjects. So a lot of things, buttons, beams and bending. So this is what you learn in that, no? Like many things, structural momentum. So then you can also find, see, let us say, for example, return to the search result. You can also find what type of material you want. You want an activity, you want an assessment, case study, or full course. So let us say you want an activity or labs or something like that. See, strength of material. The labs are also there. Okay, structural material strength. Then this is investigating the strength of magnetic field with the coil, shapes of strength. So these are all coming as an activity or lab. Okay, go to that, find out alloy, so much material, stress and strain. Students are introduced to the concept of stress and strain with example. Physics, okay, for the basic. So you can say, okay, if you want to come to my class, go learn and come. So you should be thorough with what is stress and what is strain. Then only we can go for other engineering connections and all those, see, objectives, may all those things are available, right? So this is one thing, and then you can, a lot of repositories are available. Then Merlot is there. Merlot is another repository. Excuse me. Now then Merlot is a again open source, okay, where you can have so many learning resources, members, member institutions. Okay, it is an international community of educators, learners and researchers. The first why I said, no, you can have a networking, you can share it, you need not start from the scratch, you can have a capacity building, all those things. You can add a material, you can create it, you can browse it, you can do some modification and again upload it, get credits for that, right? And then see here, let us say, for example, here, structural analysis. For research here, instead of searching on the net, you may not know which is right, which is wrong. But when you search in these type of repository, sometimes see the star mark are also giving. So that means, okay, it should be a very good structural analysis notebook. Okay, so a web application for analyzing two-dimensional interest and trans structure. We'll see what it is. Very nice. Go to the mark. Go to the material. Okay. Yes, they have taken it out. Sometimes it is gone. Structural analysis and then the, what is it? This open access textbook. See, this is a textbook. Both are the material. So structural analysis by Felix. You know here. So see, you can download it. You can buy a print copy. Okay, or you can download it as an e-copy. Here, no problem. You can download it and you can also share it with your students because it is coming under the open license. Okay, you can just give a link to this. If they have removed, let them, it is their problem. Okay, or you can download it and you can use it. The table of content, everything is there, right? See. And see the license, CC by NCNT. That is, you have to say this book is by this person. And NC is for non-commercial, no derivative. So no derivative means you cannot modify, you can use it as it is. Don't modify this book, use as it is. Then no problem at all. Okay, Temple University Press. This book has been given. So if you find this book is very apt for your students, you can link it in your LMS. Okay, so likewise, you can find so many materials are there in structural analysis. See, This is online course itself is there. Some online course, let us say for online course is there. Okay, so go to the material, go to this one. So MIT course. So holistic of historic structure. Okay, it goes there. So a link is there, right? Fine. And then or it can be anything, so many things. MIT is also there. Open textbook is also there. Tutorial is also there. So it contains identical structural analysis. And tutorial is there. So you can find, no, you can find nothing wrong. Okay. Sometimes you get like this also because they could have removed it. So you just go search here. All these things are there, online courses, structural analysis. Okay, structural mechanics, it goes to MIT. Fine. So likewise, you can go to these repositories. So repositories are OER Commons, MIT, OCW, then Merlot. Not only that, Khan Academy. You can go for Khan Academy. Okay, maybe you can find some resources there. Khan Academy is also free online courses, lessons and practice. If not for this, you can use it for your children also. Lot of things they can learn, okay, which has the content. No, the e-content is in small videos, Khan style videos will be available. So Khan Academy is other one, and then what else? Yeah, so these are the open repositories. And if you want to create the open license, go to creativecommons.org. This is the place where you can create your license. So let us say you're creating something, right? And then you want to give an open license to, or whatever, you want to share it for the whole world and give something. Okay, Creative Commons. So here, share your work. You can choose your license. It's just a click of a thing only, get started. Then you choose whatever license you wanted. Let us say, for example, it is CC BY. Maybe if I don't want adaptation, use as it is, I can choose like this, or I can choose like this. As I choose, you, the license is created. I can give my attribution also, what it is. It is a presentation or a course or a lecture notes. Okay, what it is, you can give. Then you can give the name. Like that, you can give the name. See, the code has been created here. Presentation by Mallika is licensed under Creative Commons license. It is there. What you can do is, if you are going to put it on an article or a book or something, you can cut and paste this one. Or if it is on a website, you just copy this HTML code, paste it in the web page or blog, and then automatically that sign will be there. Okay. So that is as simple as it is. Just copy this whole code and copy that, right? So if you look into any site like Wikipedia or Wikimedia, whatever it is, it comes on, you can see that license is on the bottom of the slide, okay? See that this page is available under Creative Commons Share Alike License. Likewise, you can have all these things, whatever is available under Wikis. Wiki books are there, Wiki news, Wikiversity, free course materials are there. In so all these materials, we can use it in our teaching learning process. When even see the MOOCs, know that OER journey, from OER only MOOCs arised. Okay, so it was there from 2000 here and there because of the technology, that is the internet was not available in all the country, all the places. And the awareness to the teachers were not there. People were not using in their teaching learning process. But now, and then what happened is, due to other reason also, and to create a brand image and to make the education affordability, the MOOCs came. Okay, in that also the content is open. Okay, you have all the freedom to download it and use it in your teaching learning process. The content is open. If you want a certificate only, you are paying for it. Otherwise, it is used, you can use it for your teaching, learning, and research purpose. And if you look into NPTEL, Siddhartha's also, they were inspired by the MITs, MIT professors. They can see they're also CC by NCSA. So you can see that this license is there. Another one repository, this will be the final. Okay, it goes on, I can talk for 2-3 hours, but see saksha.ac.in. So this is One India, one digital platform where you can get a lot of resources. From here you can go. Swayam Prabha, Spoken Tutorials, Fozzy, E-Yantra, then E-Journals, Virtual Labs, that vlabs.co.in, then Plagiarism Software, Urkund. All these are available free for our teaching learning purpose. This is for postgraduate. This is for other online learning. And there is a National Resources for Online Open, OER. NROER, National Repository for OER. Now they have done it for OER Commons. This is our national repository. Okay. So here, so many people have joined. So many e-resources are there. Many things are coming up. Siksha is for the school education, where not only the books, they can use the e-content when they put their phone on their books, like even in Tamil Nadu state government books, you can see that very good application is there. Through their mobiles, they are able to get additional augmented materials like videos, audios. In those days when we were learning, Tamil Taiwart or whatever it is, the teacher used to sing, and now just put the mobile on that thing, so you can hear somebody sings for you, or you can see a video, or you can see a 3D object, depending upon the e-content developed, and apps will integrate it. So they are not, it is not a dull reading only with the textbooks, additional augmenting it with additional materials like video, audio, tables, taking it to another URL link. All these are possible. For till school education, they have completed this digital infrastructure for school education. So that is there. Even state-wise, you can select it. All their books have been digitized, and many things have been augmented also. So much of e-content has been created for us to use it in our teaching learning process. So you should know that all this material is used for us, is available for us to make and use it. So we are becoming a facilitator where we can share these resources, tell them. First of all, we have to look into it, see that whether it is suitable for our audience, and then you can curate it, you can mix it, and then you can use it. Okay, so this is what I wanted to give the things. Okay, you have a lot of resources, national and international level. So even IBM, that is IIM Bangalore and IIT Bombay, they have a lot of things generated. You can just go here, you can find out a lot of resources are there. These are all open courses. Okay. it is available freely for you to do it, to learn it. Okay, so starts. Okay, next semester. Here we have some semester wise, something like that. Thermodynamic signals. Okay, it is apart from Swayam. See, in Swayam also, we have a lot of things. So this semester, I am having two courses, and it has been rerun for fourth time, I think. So it was well received, the course, and I was asked to rerun the course. You can see NIT, all courses, NITTPR. Okay, so we have courses for teachers. Okay, there are many national coordinators from school education to professional education. School education, NCERT and NIOS takes care. UGC and CEC takes care of science, arts, humanities for PG and UG. NPTEL for engineering. And now NIT Tiruchi has been also added last May when we were taking classes for them on the faculty development program. That is the time they got the order. And in due course of time, you will be seeing that they are also one of the national coordinators for engineering discipline, apart from the consortium of IITs and IIM. And here the Chennai NITTTR, we have many courses, which is, you see, this is my course, e-content development. It is an 8-week course and it is open for registration. And you see, I can just share it in our, any teacher can take. It is not that it is for computer science or civil, any teacher. And just you can click on review the course. It's an 8-week course. You can learn many, many tools, okay, in that, where you can create your resources, or it gives a fundamental knowledge and skill to create your own content. And of course, I have another course. This is one course. So this time, it is starting in July 26th, it is starting. So far, 964 people have enrolled. My first time, there were 4,900 teachers. It was really, it gave me a very motivation for me to do further. Such a good feedback I received. I am just proud to share that with you. Then what else? So there are a lot of resources. Only thing, we should have time, patience, motivation to learn. And of course, because we are all teachers, we have to, other whether we are taking it down, we can have to facilitate our students. Here another course, OER and Open Education Resource, Open Education Practice. So this, previously it was not open. They said, okay, we want, please run this course again. Just a day before yesterday only, it was made available. I think this is again, I don't know, fourth time or fifth time they are running this course. I will also share this with you. So you can tell your colleagues, or you can also, if you want, you can just join this course. It is totally free. If you want to write an exam and get a certification, then you have to pay that 1,000 rupees. Otherwise, you can, without certification also, you can learn. That is, it is an open content. So with this, I will end my session on OER, okay, Open Educational Resources. So if you have any doubts, or if you have any questions to me, you can definitely ask me. I'll be happy to share whatever I know. Okay, if, can we have a small quiz?
Or yes.
I will just share it. So I request all of you to, whatever we have learned, okay, whatever we have learned, only I'm going to ask. So just to reinforce it, so I will just have it. Otherwise, okay, once again, right, I will share this. Okay. Am I sharing the screen? Okay. I am just sharing an URL in the chat box. Click that. It is with the quizzes. Click that. So this will be like very interesting. I request all of you to join the session just to check our knowledge, right? And it will be very, very interesting. So many things I have opened. I close all these things. Okay, are you joining it? Okay. I have shared that URL in the thing. You can put your names, okay? Don't put SK, PK, because I do not know. You have to say, okay, Suresh, yes, Raja, MA, or even Raja is sufficient, okay? Short names, at least you have to say Santosh Kumar, like that. Okay, so it will, there will be 10 questions. Each question will be having 30 seconds. Okay, you have 30 seconds to answer each question. Okay, I'll share the content. People have, no participants have joined. Why? You don't want to get, take the quiz? Madam, what is it? People are there?
Ma'am, yes, ma'am, you have joined, ma'am.
Joined, okay.
You're starting, join it.
Yeah, participants, you please join in the quiz. Madam has already shared a link in the chat box.
You are joined, ma'am.
Uh-huh. Okay. Yes, 26 part. Very good. Okay, I didn't refresh it. Very nice, very nice. Very happy to see all of you. Right. 28 participants, 29. Good. Okay. So more than half of it, right? 30. So shall I start? Okay, so there will be questions and there will be choice. Read the question, choose the answer. For choosing your answer, 30 seconds will be there. All right? Okay, start. What can be a good? So, yes, Shamim Isla. Okay, so out of 31, 25 people have answered. Out of 25, 22 people got it right. Good to know. Next question. Yeah, 23 people have got it, have answered it. Oh, okay. So this should be, it should be correct as well as you should be fast. That is what it is showing. Don't worry. Keep doing it. Yeah, repay is not an option. Retain, revise, reuse, remix, redistribute. Okay, next question. Sharing content. Four people have answered. Good to know. Oh, okay. Right. So 12 have got it right. Redistribute. Okay. So when you are sharing the content with your student, it is reuse. Reuse is, you can use it in in your class, in your videos, like that. That is reuse. Okay. So next question. So what does attribution means you have to give credit, no, to the author. Okay, Riyas is now on the top. Yeah, giving credit to the author, to the original. So 14 people have got it right. Very nice. So 22 people have answered this question out of 23. All right. Again, Riyas is in the top. Okay. Yeah. See here, CC BY means give attribution for non-commercial purpose. No derivatives, no changes. That is only 6 people have got it right. Okay. What does CC0? Zero, you know, I have showed you what it is. CC0 means. Okay, 20 people have given your answers. Yes. Now new people are coming. Padma, Maria. Good. Public domain. CC0 means it is in public domain. You can do whatever. No rights reserved. Just opposite to your copyright. Are not able to answer because short time, 30 seconds only I have given. Right. Okay, now Maria is catching up. Vijay. Right. So CC by NC ND is the most restricted, right? Only 5 people. See, I showed you. It is similar, no? For NPTEL, for MIT, OCW, it is similar. for NPTEL, it is CC by NC, non-commercial share alike. Good. 23 people have answered it. Right. So Britannica Encyclopedia is not associated with open education resources, whereas William Flora, UNESCO, and other things are associated with that, right? Creative Commons. Okay. The next question. Okay, Uma Maheshwari. Okay, attribution is associated with all CC. Okay, that is what. So 14 people have got it right. So that is their last question. Now you want, last minute there was a big change. Okay, now you want to see who has won. So we'll see that leaderboard. Great. So third place goes to Maria, second place to Riaz, and first place to Uma Maheshwari. Okay, right. So here comes the list. Even I can download the thing in the download the result. Okay, I can also find out the individual score. 7, 7, 7. All the first four people got 7 out of 10. But since the they were fast, no, Uma Maheshwari, it was giving. Otherwise, if you want to have only the correct answers, you can get the scores like this also. Okay, so this is the final chart. I can also download the result. Okay, I can download the result as an Excel file, save it. I can mail it to the see, this is how the analytics will be available. So this is the class wise. Okay, how many people attended, how many correct, how many wrong, all those things. And then player wise, I can see what is their score, 70, 70, 60, 70. Okay, on which, when they played on which, like Chrome or in Chrome mobile. See, all the details are also available. Okay, so some people were not able to do it. It is also available. So all these things you can save it and then do it, right? So this is one of the engagement tool apart from the Mentimeter. You have Kahoot. So we have lot of resources like that, so that you can use it in your teaching learning process to make it very engaging and effective. Okay, so with this, I will stop my presentation. I think they can hear. Sorry for it. Okay, 15 minutes. Okay. Good, good to know. So, thanks. I congratulate all of you for actively participating it and giving your answers. Hope you have also enjoyed doing it, right?
Yeah, yes, madam. Thank you so much, like, for your informative sessions and also for giving, like, your lectures were so exhaustive that you have given all the information about the open educational resources available the present scenario, especially in this pandemic situation, all the teachers are forced to take the classes through online mode. So it was such an informative session from you. So thank you very much, madam. And also the quiz was also very interactive. I hope all the participants might have enjoyed this particular session. So thank you so much, madam.
Thank you. Best wishes. Be safe. Be well. Thank you very much.
Yes. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Please join for the photo session. So all the participants, you please join for the photo session along with the madam.
I can see Riya's. Yeah, I can. I wanted to see some people. I can remember Suresh. Okay. Then Uma Mahesh. Mariam, where's Mariam? Yeah, okay, good. If time permits, I will be looking into it, but within the short time.
Thank you.
Thanks for the opportunity given for me to share my experience and expertise. Thank you very much.
Madams, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I request the participants to please wait. So please join for the afternoon session at 1:45 because it's already time 12:45. So please join for the session at 1:45. So we have the test.